Hey everyone, and once again, welcome to WsCube Tech English channel. Myself, Omar Taskeer. Guys, in the previous video, we basically discussed about what are display campaigns and what are the different options, what are the different settings in display campaigns. We have also seen a very basic walkthrough of the different settings which were there in the display campaign. So, in this particular video, we will be basically talking about one of the very important concepts behind display campaign, which is targeting, right? So, we'll be discussing about what are the different targeting options which are available through which we can target audience in display network or for the display campaign. So this is what we are going to discuss in this specific video. But before continuing or before coming to the topic, please do subscribe the channel and also press the notification bell so that you do not miss any important video, right? So let's begin and see how can we target audience in Google's display network. So first of all, we will start creating a campaign, right? So I am at the campaign tab and let's click on new campaign and let's start creating a campaign. So we'll start by creating a campaign like without goal guidance, and then we'll be coming over here for the display, right? And within display, we have to select the standard display campaign and we have to enter our website, right? So let's put our website, let's copy our website from here and let's put it over, right? So I'll also mention www and then we will continue this thing. And next, we will directly come to the targeting option because we have to explore the targeting option, that what are targeting options available in Google's display campaign type, right? So as we come down and at this ad group level, so one thing which is very important and you have to remember is you cannot set targeting at any other level. So targeting is there at the ad group level. Whenever you are looking to create your audience for display network or for display campaigns, you have to come to this ad group level. So whenever you want to split some audiences, whenever you want to test with some audiences, what you have to do is you have to basically create different ad groups. So for each ad group, you can create different audience because audience's option is available at this ad group level, right? So you can simply put the name of this ad group. This is very basic. Now coming down, what options do we have, right? So these are the main options which are there for the display network audience. So here you can create audience based on the people, right? So who you want to reach, right? So you have to define people based on audiences, based on interest, based on their demographics, or based on both. You can select this audience option over here, or you can select this demographic if you want to create an audience based on the demographic only, right? So the first option that you see over here is like who you want to reach, right? So you can target people. And the second broad option that you see over here is content, I mean where you want to show your ad. So you have got two options. Either you select that I want to reach to these people and these people are having these kind of interest, or I want to reach these kind of websites, or I want to reach these kind of apps. So you have two options. Either you can target people, right, or you can target the different content. So you have two options over here. These are the two options, right? So first of all, let's begin with demographic, right? So you have different options like gender, age, parental status, and household income. So you have all these options. You can select anyone from here to target audience based on demographic. And then you have audience section over here. So if we come to this browse, this audience targeting is divided into this like parts over here. So you can select audiences based on demographic. This is very detailed demographic like parental status, marital status and everything. So in this particular video, we are only going to talk about the detailed demographic and the affinity, right? So we'll discuss this thing. So once we come to this detailed demographic, you can see you can target based on, you can target parent of infants who are like 0 to 1 year. You can target parents of toddlers, you can target parents of preschoolers. So you have any business or the service which is there for preschoolers, right, for the kids of somewhere around 4 to 5 years. So as we all know that kids of 4 to 5 years are not going to come to internet to buy something, right? So it is better to target their parents. If you are having any service which is there for the preschoolers or any kind of product also which is there for preschoolers, so you cannot directly target preschoolers because preschoolers are not generally on internet, right? So you have to target their parents. So this detailed demographic section has, that you can actually target parent of preschoolers. You have option of targeting parent of grade schoolers also, and you have also option of targeting parents of teens, right? So you have to make sure that you have to be very clear that what is your buyer's persona, or what kind of people you are looking for, or what kind of product you are or service you are into, right? So you have to be very clear with all these things, then only you can create the detailed demographic audience over here, right? So let's close this thing. And then you have option of marital status. So you can target people based on their marital status, like single, in relationships or married. Now coming to the education part, you can target people based on the current college students category. If they are right now they are into college, right, they are studying something, you can target them. Or you can target them on other parameters like high school graduate, bachelor's degree, advanced degree. So you have so much of options. Like you can also target people based on the status of their home ownership. Like if they are homeowners, they are having their own home, or they are the renters, right? So if they are the renters, they might require different kind of services which are there only for the renters. Like, so coming back, we have other options also. Affinity. Affinity is basically when you are having a long-term interest. There is a difference between affinity and in-market audience. This is again a very important thing. When you'll come back, we'll see in-market audience and affinity audience, right? So there is difference between in-market audience and affinity audience. So guys, affinity audience is basically that audience which has a deep interest in anything. Like, so if I am having interest in music, like, so I will be placed into affinity audience. But if I am searching for music for a small period of time, and that is basically in market. See, if I have interest in technology, that is a separate thing. I am looking for a mobile phone, that is a separate thing. Because when I am looking for a mobile phone, it does not indicate that I am having a strong affinity towards technology or mobile phone, right? So it's the need. I am searching for the mobile phone. As soon as I'll buy it, I'll stop searching, right? So this is basically in market audience, or the characteristics of in market audience. They search something very aggressively, and when they buy it, they stop searching. This is in market audience. So people who are actively into market searching for something comes under the in market audience category. Whereas if I am the guy and I am having some interest in anything, it's a long term interest. Like if I am having interest in sports, it's a long term interest. If I am having interest in music, it's a long term interest, right? If I am having interest in cricket, it's a long term interest. If I am having interest in politics, it's a long-term interest. So every time I browse internet, I basically go to different websites which are related with politics if I'm having interest in politics. So these kind of signals or these kind of activities from the users give signal to Google that, okay, these are the set of the people who are basically interested into politics. And as they are, like, they are following this thing from a longer period of time, or their activity shows that, okay, they are following these things from a longer period of time, which means that they are going to come into the affinity audience. So concluding in a very single line, affinity audience is that set of audience which has interest in anything, and that interest should be for a longer period of time. So if you want to target those kind of people, you have this option. So if you want to target people who have interest, a long-term interest in banking and finance, you can target those people. If you want to target the people who have a long-time interest in, like, coffee shops, right, in fast food, in food, they are foodies, right? So it is basically if they have that interest, and that interest is a long-term interest. It's not a short-term interest. They are not having interest in food and dining for like 2 days or 3 days or 5 days or for a month, right? So whenever their interest or whenever their affinity towards anything is for a longer period of time, they are basically kept under this affinity audience characteristics. So within this affinity audience characteristics, we have different options. So what I will suggest you, or what I will recommend you, is please go through all these options. Once you will go through all these options, you will come to know that what kind of targeting options are available there, and that will help you in setting your campaigns afterwards, right? So you have to do this thing. Now coming back over here, right, coming back over here within this affinity audience tab, we have custom affinity audience. So as the name suggests, these are the predefined affinity audience that you have. And then you have option of creating custom affinity audience that we can also do. So you can create different new audiences, right? Custom affinity audiences also, and those custom affinity audiences will appear over here, right? So these are the different options that you have actually, right? So you can also create custom affinity audience, which is like this, your custom audience. You can click over here, your custom audience, and this is the custom affinity audience, right? So you can target people who browse basically different kind of websites, right? You can target people who basically go to different types of apps. You can target people who visit different places. So this is, again, you are targeting people, you are basically creating audiences based on different affinities, and that is basically kind of custom, right? Because we are creating it. So in this particular video, we basically discussed about that we have option of creating audiences based on the demographic, and that too very detailed, like marital status, parental status, and education. And then we have option of this affinity audience. And affinity audience means that I want to target the people who are having deep interest into anything, right? So we have discussed these two things in this particular video. Further, we will be talking about other options also in upcoming videos, that what are these options and how they are going to help us in creating the audience. So that's it for this specific video. See you in the next video. Till then, goodbye.